must feel really hairs. It's pretty, but weird. Like me. Building up the darkness. So I'm beige. Apparently nutty beige as well. Who knew? Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands. Hence the accent. And today I am giving you my review on the new Catrice mini palettes. The 5 in a box. They have 4 and I have all 4 here. They retail for 4 euros. I bought mine at Boozy Shop, but they are also available at Cosmetic for Less. I will link both sites down below. I'm going to go per palette and there will be a timestamp in the description box for, yeah, per palette basically. Catrice is a cruelty-free brand, but not all the palettes are vegan. So the palettes that are vegan are this one, the Warm Spice Look. And so basically the 2 neutrally ones, the 2 brownie ones are vegan. The Modern Smoky Look and this one, the Soft Rose Look, contain carmine. So these are not vegan, but they are cruelty-free. And if you're thinking, how is that possible? Cruelty-free is not regulated. The term cruelty-free is not regulated. And basically, it just means that it's not tested on animals. That's what it means. And if it's not, if it's vegan, no animal parts were used. So that is... That is it, you know. If you want to know what carmine is crushed bugs and has been used for specifically reddish dyes for very, very long time. And if you don't want that, then you know at least that palette 20 and 40 contain carmine and the other 2 do not. That is going to be it. I don't know if I already said this. I think I did. Grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes palette number 1. What was it called again? Golden Nude Look. The shimmers feel really nice and creamy. The mattes feel nice and pigmented as well. The only thing I have to say though is that the lighter matte don't really show up on me. It's going to be a very simple look because I just kind of want to see how they perform. Look, I'm going to start with the middle shade because that is the way that I like it. And let's see how deep and dark we can get it. So I'm starting with a fluffier brush. It is a bit powdery in the pan. Oh, I need an eye base first. Oh, I almost forgot. Let's use the Kiko Milano eye base today. Because I can. And I don't have any nails on now. So I just use my fingertips. If I do have nails, I usually use a brush. And then tap over it extra with my fingers. And I also bring it underneath my eye. So yeah, back to the shade. So let's tap it on. That's how I usually start. And if you start with a fluffier brush, it's more distributed. And if you start with a denser brush, you pack it on a bit more. The reason I'm tapping it on is because I haven't set my base. Now this lightest shade is in here, you could use to set your eye base with. I usually don't do that unless I'm working with specific shades, but I usually don't go for that. You could use it to blend out though as well. That is how I would use a shade like this. I'm going to go back to the same shade but with a denser brush just to build it up a little bit. Okay, nice. Okay, and now I'm going to go to the darkest shade. Let's see how it performs. And this is going to go in the outer corner and the crease. It's a nice and pigmented shade. It blends into the previous shade very, very nicely. I don't really have a lot of fallout either, so that is good. Okay, let's get a very small brush for the bottom lash line. Let's see if I can get it any deeper. I don't think so. Now I have a very, very dense brush and I'm really packing it on in the outer corner. And then I can get it kind of true to pan. I'm also drawing a line of the darker shade to frame my eye a little bit because I think that's pretty. Okay, it is shimmer time. Now, for shimmers, I always use a shimmer primer. And this is the one from NYX that I have here. I will show you how much I use on the brush. It is just kind of a wormy thingy that goes on my lid first just to spread it out a little bit. And then I can be a bit more precise. And I'm basically following my eyeball. Yeah, again, I just want to use them all. So this one is going on the outer corner. And then this one is going to go more in. I'm going to start with the lighter one though. Or not. No, I'm going to start with the darker one. Let's see how I like it on the lid. Maybe I will put it on top of the entire lid. And then just the lighter shade in the inner corner. I'm not sure yet. Okay, I'm going to flip my brush for the other side. I'm going to go to the lighter shade. Ah, yeah, also very, very pretty. I'm going to drag it over, flip the brush for the other side. Oh, on the darker color a little bit more. Swipe that over. So that is what I'm doing. One side light, one side dark. Cutesy. Then with that darkest matte, I'm just going to make sure that here the outer part is blended as well. Could even blend it over a little bit. It's a very, very pretty look. I kind of want a little bit extra, as I do usually. Let's first get a little bit of that lighter shimmer here. Just a tiny bit. And then that darker brown a little bit more packed on. What do I want to do with eye pencil? I don't know. Let me do that eye first. I'm grabbing a bronzy pencil for the lashes, because I feel that that dark brown kind of wants to fade a bit. I'm just putting it between my lashes. So the pencil I'm putting in my waterline and in my inner corner is also one from Catrice. It's in the shade Bright Lavender. Then I'm taking my BH Cosmetics Duo Highlight Palette for the shade Double Up. If you live in Europe, this is available at BH Cosmetics Germany. If you are in the US, Ulta has it, or at least had it. I don't know if they still have it, but they had it. I'm just going to put that here and in the inner corner a little bit. Just to give it a little bit of extra interest. And this is a very easy way to kind of, I don't know, spruce up a very neutrally look a little bit more. Okay, I'm going to finish off this look with liner lashes and, I don't know, a lip balm or something, because I'm going to wear a mask in a minute anyway. So let me do that and I will be back to give you my thoughts on the palette and show you the final look. Okay, here it is, the final look with palette number one. Falsies are from Primark in the style Paris, and the Lippy is also from Catrice. It's one of their lip balms, but this is in the shade Golden Ginger, which is, well, basically this shade. They are very, very nice and comfortable. I have three now. So yeah, let me give you some quick thoughts on the palette. I think that the color story is very neutral for me, but it is very pretty. And this is more of a, I don't know, is this a warmer tone? I actually think it's more of a neutral tone. Why am I saying that? Because this one, which is number three, this is warm, for me at least. So yeah, we will get to that, but not right now. But yeah, I think the shimmers are very, very pretty. I kind of could have done without this shade, but I can see it having a purpose. The shimmers are gorgeous. The mattes blend into each other very, very nicely. They are a little bit more of a softer formula. I don't know how they will wear throughout the day, but I do like the look that came out of it. And yeah, for €4, if you like the color story, this is definitely one to check out. This was it for palette number one. Let's go to palette number two. Palette number two is called Soft Rose Look, and it's very pretty. It's a very pretty one, actually. Swatches feel like the previous palette, soft. The mattes feel soft, the shimmers feel nice and creamy. So I'm going to start with the lightest shade today. So I'm going to tap this on. Okay, I want to pack it on a little bit more in the inner eye part area, so I'm grabbing a smaller brush. Okay, with the brush that I have now, I'm going to go to the pink. Oh, no. I'm going to go to the pinky. And it's going to go lower and about, I don't know, 3/4 in. And this shade shows up very nicely though. I want depth. So I'm going to go to the darkest shade. Spoiler alert, it's going to go in the outer corner and the crease. Oh, this packs a punch. Yeah, this is my kind of dark brown. You know, the cooler toned, I really, really like that. Okay, tiny bit of that pink. But I don't really want to blend the line that I made here. I just want to place it a little bit higher or just above. Okay, I'm going to go to the NYX Glitter Primer. Nothing fancy. It's the way that I used it in the last look as well. Okay, my camera did something weird. I don't know. But the glitter primer is on my eyes. I'm going to go to the darkest one. It's going to go over my lid. And then this one I'm going to reserve for the inner corner and there. I like this a lot. Okay, I'm going to go back to that brown matte. Let's do dark and smoky. I have here a dark brown eye pencil from Pure. I'm also going to put it a little bit on my lashes because I want it really dark and dramatic like me. I have the lightest one, lightest shimmer left, so I'm grabbing that one on a stiff brush. Let's see what it does. Dry. Oh, that's not too shabby at all, actually. Smudging it here. I do want a little bit, or not. Yeah, I do want a little bit of that other shimmer on my lashes, or just below. Fallout City, but that's okay. I like it if it is a little sparkly. I like this. So let me finish off the look and then I will be back. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. I feel very witchy today. I thought let's go full out dramatic. So I did a big wing, for me at least, a whale tail wing. And I also pulled it in more in the inner corner. So I kind of framed my eye. Then I took a little bit of the eye pencil again and smudged it for the rest in the waterline to make it a little bit darker. And then I paired it with a black lip. Well, it's not technically a lipstick. It's just an eye pencil in black that I use as a lip if I want a black lip. Let's give you my quick thoughts on this palette. I like this palette more than the first one. I like the color story more. I feel like the darker shade is also darker. But it could very well be that this is more cool toned and shows up better on me. I don't know. But I feel like I can get more depth with this one versus the first one. And the lightest shade also shows up for me, which makes it a little bit more versatile. For the rest, it performed the way that the first one did. The mattes blend out beautifully. The shimmers are gorgeous. And yeah, this is apparently what you can pull out of. Did you think that I could pull this out of this little palette? I didn't. But yeah, I think it's a fun look nonetheless. Let me know down below what you think of it. And let's get ready for palette number 3. Palette number 3 is called the Warm Spice Look. And it is just, yeah, an accurate description. That was the word. Yeah, an accurate description, I think. This palette also swatches like all the other palettes. They all kind of swatch the same. That's basically what I wanted to say. I'm going to go to, the center shade. And let's see if I can achieve a halo-ish eye. So let's put this in the crease. And see if I can kind of keep the shape a little bit rounded. I am actually going to go to that lightest shade that I used. See how it works when I blend out this shade. As an eraser shade, it works very, very nicely. And that is the way that it works for me. Now, if you are lighter, you will probably get it to show up. If you are darker, you probably get it to show up. But for me, it is basically my skin tone. So, yeah. Okay, let's just, I don't know, with the brush I have here. Because I have it, go back to that middle shade again. And just blend over everything. And just put it here in the inner and outer corner. Just to give a little bit of extra definition. I don't even know if I need to do that because I also have the shimmers, you know. I'm going to go to my Morphe E36, and mine is just a very small kind of pencil brush without the tip. You know, I'm going to go to the darkest shade in the palette. And let's build up the darkness in the inner and outer corner. And I truly do love the way that halo and spotlight eyes look, especially on other people. But yeah, for me, I don't know. Maybe I just need to do that more often, you know? Now I'm taking kind of a blending brush with a little bit of the darker color, just to have it a little bit on my brush. And I'm going to blend out the edges a bit. I think I do want to connect it just a tiny bit. This is a sticky shade. My base should kind of be set a little bit because of the previous shade, but it almost appears not wanting to move. So let me get a fluffy brush and a little bit of the second color, the middle shade, you know, and just blend a little bit. So yeah, I also wanted a little bit more underneath my eye. I'm just fading it a little bit with this brush, just making the line a little less harsh. Nice, let's see if I can replicate it there. Now I do kind of wing it out, and the reason is my eye shape. So usually when you see this kind of eye, it's really kept round, the shape is round. But when I do that, because my eyes are deep set and a little bit older and they hang here, it looks weird. Or at least I think it looks weird. So that is the reason that I'm building up the darkness a little bit more higher here. I can, however, grab a little bit of that middle shade. Right. I'm going to grab the glitter primer, but for the inner part. So I think I need a smaller brush for that. And a very tiny amount of glitter primer. I'm going to concentrate it in the center. And then tap a little bit here. Let's go to the darkest for the outer parts, and then the lighter one for the middle. And it's going to go a little bit more in the middle as well, because I have that, it's a gorgeous shade by the way, because I have that dark brown on the outside. I kind of want to keep it there as well, you know. Okay, and then I am going to place the center shade. Because the primer is still a bit tacky and it has the maximum amount of grip, I will finesse it in a bit. I just want to place it. Okay, now I'm going to finesse. I'm just going to grab a blending brush because it does not really matter. I'm going to start with the dark shade here. And then just on the border, very, very small circles. And I'll probably go back to the shimmer shade in a bit. Yeah, right now, but with a drier brush. So I'm probably going to create fallout, but what can you do about it? Well, not do this. Yes, I have a little bit of that brown, but it's on the dry brush now, and I'm just going to put it on the border. So I'm bringing the shimmer in a little bit more, and then I'm really going to pack on some of that matte to get it, I don't know, you almost get it like a satin then. Yeah, and I am connecting it a little bit in the crease because I think that for my eye shape that is prettier. So let's start with the bronze. I'm leaving a gap in the middle. And then I think I'm going to grab this one from Essence. I think it's in Gold Bling. Yes, it's a long lasting one. It's not their best though, but yeah. Yes, and I also want the shimmers there. So with my Morphe brush, I'm going to go to the darker shimmer first. I'm just going to press it here. I don't really feel like I need to spray it. I will with the lighter shade, I think. Okay, now I'm cleaning the brush on a microfiber towel that I have. Going to go to the lightest shade and spray it. So pick up shade first, then spray, and then put it in the center. I do like that. I want it a little bit more intense though. Oh yeah, I forgot to mix the... How can I forget to mix this part, really? Why didn't you say anything? So I have here the highlighter from Catrice More Than Glow in the shade Platinum Ultimate Platinum Glaze. I forgot to put highlighter on the face, but that doesn't matter. This is going to go in the very, very, very center, center, center. Let's see. Oh yeah, it's pretty. And it is okay if it mixes in with a darker shade, because it's actually very pretty. It doesn't really change that shade too much. I like this, guys. I'm going to finish everything off with liner and lashes and a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the completed look and give you some quick thoughts on this specific palette. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. I chose falsies that are a little bit more open and a little bit more round in shape instead of the flared ones that I usually go for. These are from AOA Studios in the style Jackie. And the lippy is from Juvia's Place. It is one of the chocolate ones in the shade Toffee. I really like how this look came out, guys. When I first got the bundle in, or the palettes in, I thought that this would be my least favorite. I was expecting this to be a one look with the palette and then to give it away. But I actually think I'm going to keep it, because I do really, really like the way that this is looking. I like the vibrancy that I got. I like the depth. And I loved the way that the shadows performed. The only thing that I kind of noticed in this palette was that the darkest shade felt a little bit more sticky than from the other two palettes. Not that that's a bad thing at all. It means basically that it can layer a little bit better. But that is what I noticed. And yeah, basically this lighter shade, the matte, it doesn't show up for me, at least not now. But also it does kind of have its purpose. I can use it to blend out one of the shades. I could use it to set my base. I usually don't do that, but if I want to, I can. And if I want a really, really soft blend, so for instance, if I want to use the darkest shade maybe on its own, I sometimes like that to then define the eye, you know, then I do use a shade like this, because then I want the blend to be as soft as possible. And in that instance, when I use that technique, I do like to set my base. And then that shadow is perfect for me, at least. So yeah, this was palette number 3. We have one palette left. And if you need a refill on your drink and your snack, get it now, because here comes the last palette. Palette number 4 is called Modern Smoky Look. When I look at it, I have two distinct sides. I have the dark bluey gray side and I have the browny side. If you see the swatches, it does go together, but on first glance it kind of doesn't, you know? I don't know, I really want to play here today, and then to make it easier myself, I'm going to start with that one. That's the way it is going to be today. So let's go to a very large brush. And the reason I'm now basically going to set my eyeshadow base is because I want a very soft blend, at least the top part, you know? So basically I'm going to create a smoky eye. But I'm not going to start with the brown, I'm going to start with the lightest shade. So now I'm going to go to that gray shade, very lightly. And I'm going to tap it on first, but again very, very lightly, because I'm going to build up this shade. Well, basically the way I work with these shades. And because I'm working on top of an eyeshadow already, it should give me a very nice and soft blend that I can then build upon, you know? This doesn't work with every formula, but a lot of the time, especially if you have a stickier shade, like a sticky black for instance, this should do the trick. And because you go like this, lightly, it won't go patchy as quickly, because you don't have to blend as much. Now I'm going to deepen it up, just with the same brush. So I'm picking up a little bit more shadow, and I'm going to tilt my head back, and I'm going to start in the crease, basically where my eye ball stops. Yeah, on the low part of my skull. I think that's the part. When you tilt your head back, usually you kind of see a shadow, and that is where I'm placing this. And then I'm looking forward to see if my placement is good. Lightly blending it in the first layer. You know, I'm going to go back to the first brush and a tiny bit of that very light shade just to make sure that the edges are nice. Now I'm going to pack it on even lower, so in the outer corner and the lower crease. Now if you don't see this when you tilt your head back, just draw a line where you basically want your crease to be and where you want your shadow to deepen. Okay, I want a clean soft brush just to go over the layers and make sure that they blend into each other nicely. And then basically the mats are done. Okay, then I'm going to go to this one. It does pick up with this brush very, very nicely. Ooh, that's a pretty color. I do kind of have to swirl my brush in, because it feels like this formula is just a little bit more harder pressed. It's very pretty though. Okay, let's go back to that dark gray. Make sure that everything is nice. And let's finesse it a little bit, basically. That's what I wanted to say. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm putting a pencil from Catrice in Absolute Graziness on my waterline and on my lash line to give it really that smoky effect. Then I'm going to go with a small brush into that shimmer shade. I'm going to spray it. I'm going to put that on top. Okay, now I want the lighter shimmer here in the inner eye part area. I'm just going to pick it up with that smaller brush. I think I should have sprayed it. So let's do that. Cutesy. Now if you want it more intense, you can put a highlighter there as well. But I think this is nice. So yeah, this is it for the eyes so far. I am going to put on liner lashes, choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the completed look and give you my overall thoughts on these palettes. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. I like it. I thought let's be extra dramatic today and put on my Kylies, which are the more dramatic ones that I have in my collection from Primark. And the lippy is from Catrice. It is one of their generations matte comfort matte in the shade Llama Pool, which is a little purpley cooler toned brown. I don't know, I like it. I thought let's wear it again. So let me quickly go over what I think about this palette before I go on about my thoughts on the entire collection. I really like this one. I knew I was going to like this one because this was the first one that drew my attention. It was the one that kind of reminded me a little bit of the mini Lila from Natasha Denona. But yeah, it's also of course not really. Let me kind of show them then to you side by side, if I can do that without digging my nails in. So this is the difference. So yeah, the mini Lila is Lila, at least three shades. And this one is, yeah, not. I do feel though that this is a more cohesive color story than this one. And why do I say that? Because all these shades complement each other. It doesn't look like it at first glance. That is why I actually opted out of this one. But if you swatch it out, you see that it is gray enough to pair well with this one. Now that I don't have used it with this one, it is more blue because of the shimmer. So you can really nicely play with it. The only thing that is kind of different for me is this shimmer compared to the rest of the collection, because it, when I swatch it, it swatches a little bit thin. It is almost a little bit sticky and a little bit harder pressed in a pen. And then I know that I kind of need to work with a different brush. So the brush that I use for formulas like that is this one from Yesup. Zoeva has the exact same thing. This one is only available in a set. The Zoeva one is available as a single brush as well. And this is the 233 cream shader. And why do I want this one? Because if you look, I hope it will focus on the brush, you can see that the slanted part that goes into a point, this one is pretty long. So you have a lot of surface area to pick up shimmers. And with that blue shade, I kind of did this. So I wiggled my brush in a little bit to basically push the particles a little bit more into the bristles. The one that will probably also work is this one. And this one is from the Body Shop, but also has that slanted, yeah, kind of openness, but it is very wide as well. So this one will, I think, work as well. But I think you need to build it up a little bit more. Otherwise, just use your finger or maybe a sponge tip. I think then it will pick up as well. But this is just my... Maybe I just need to order some from Zoeva as well. Because if I'm not mistaken, Zoeva is cruelty-free. Yes, I don't know. And this was bought before I went cruelty-free on my channel. But I do use it almost every day. So, yeah, I do feel that... this is the only palette that I see in two different sides. All the other palettes I kind of see as one. Here I kind of see this part and I see this part. You can very nicely combine them, but I do see two distinct sides. But that is how I see the palette. That being said, I think this is a perfect palette for a lot of people to use from day to night. You know what I mean? So yeah, I have for a lot of people, I think now at least a night time, I don't know, clubbing look, no one can go clubbing now, but that does not matter. Yeah, I really, really like this palette. Now let's go then to what I feel about the entire collection. The first thing that I know that people said is it looks like Natasha Denona, the Natasha Denona mini palettes, and I agree. Now I don't feel that Catrice is a specific duping brand, but yeah, apparently they are. They do have a build your own palette option, and it was like this but then bigger. So basically the normal 5-pan palettes from Natasha Denona, that size, but then it was just without shades and you can put 5 shades in. So this kind of format, this kind of look is not weird for me, having kind of grown up with Catrice. Does that make any sense? And I knew of Catrice before I knew of Natasha Denona. So there's that. I can compare these palettes only to the Mini Lila because this is the only one that I have. The size is the same. The grams are the same. And basically the look and the feel of them is the same. The difference is this is 25 euros and this is 4. Also, the difference is, I feel at least, that the mattes from the Natasha Denona one are... Yeah, I don't know. You know, I heard so many things about her. And then when I got the palette and I was like, it's kind of a... Yeah, the mattes that are in here, with the exception of this one, are kind of hard to work with. It's a very sticky, hard-pressed formula. And the shimmers, while this one is gorgeous, I kind of really have to work for it to get it to really nicely show up on my eye. So I was a little bit disappointed by this palette. I do get compliments every time that I use it. And if I want a shade from the palette, it's this one, because this one is just gorgeous. Let's then go to this. Now, already said the palettes retail for 4 euros or 3.99 for me. There are 4 and I have all 4 in front of me. So I think the formula is very, very nice. I think the mattes are very, very good quality, and I have a lot of things to compare it to. I can compare it to Indie. I can compare it to more expensive palettes. Hell, I can compare it to this one. I think these are better. In my opinion, at least. I think these are very easy to work with. They are not... they are soft enough to work with easily, but they are not so soft that you blend them away when you blink, you know? Overall, the collection, the mattes are very easy to work with. The shimmers are very, very pretty. They are maybe not the most foiled, but it is a formula and a look that I really like, especially if you have more texture. If you have texture on your eyelids, you don't, or at least I don't want a formula that is like a mirror, you know? Because it just emphasizes... everything. And I like the way that it looks when it is very, very blingy, and sometimes I just don't care. I want very blingy, but overall, for basically day-to-day wear, I like shimmers like this a lot. I think these are the two most versatile, just because of the fact that there are some interesting shades in here and not specifically only neutrals. And this is the soft rose look and the smoky look. This palette is the most surprising for me, and that is the warm, spicy look. I felt that when I ordered all the palettes that this would have been my least favorite. I actually think it's my favorite, guys. Even though I love the look that I have now, this I could see me grabbing on an everyday basis. And I did not think that would happen, because usually I don't really gravitate towards warm neutrals. But apparently, in this case, I do. And I think it is just the smallness... the curated palette, and then the specific tones that they did. I think they're amazing. And in my opinion, again, the only one that I can compare it to is the Mini Lila. These are way, way better. That's my opinion. Yeah, I can make everything show up with the exception of some of the very, very light shades. And yeah, it's just, I don't use shades like that often. If I do, I kind of use them as I did today. So I think that if you are very fair, you can make everything work. Maybe not specifically this one, because it's a very, very pale shade. I think that if you are my shades, so basically, I don't know, the hazelnut beigey kind of thing, you know, the beige, you can make almost all the colors show up. If you are medium, I think you can make most of these work. If you are tan, I think you can make at least this one work, which is the warm spice. And the others, I don't know. I don't know, to be quite honest with you, because I have no, I don't know. So if you have a deeper complexion than me, please let me know if you have tried these and how they fare for you. I think though that if you see these in store or if you see them online and you're like, ooh, I kind of like that one, go for it. Just go for it, because formula wise, it is amazing. Just saying, €4 for these per palette. Guys, it's a steal. It really is a steal. And Catrice is really blowing me away lately. Now, I will leave Cosmetic for Less down below. I bought them at Boozy Shop, but I will leave Cosmetic for Less and Boozy Shop down below. Unfortunately, these are not available in the USA, because Cosmetic for Less is currently not can currently not ship to the USA. So if you want to get your hands on these and you live in America, you kind of need to have someone who lives in a country that Cosmetic for Less does ship to, you know, and then ask if they will send it to you, you know, something like that. And that is going to be it. I will leave my Catrice and Essence, it's one playlist, my Catrice playlist down at the end screen for your, down at the end screen. I will leave my Catrice playlist at the end screen for your end screen for your viewing pleasure. Wow, I think I need coffee. This is going to be it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know your thoughts down below. Have you tried them? Do you want to? Do you not want to? Let's talk about it in the comment section. For now, thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to go to the side a little bit so I can give a special thank you to my members. If you want to become a member, there's a link in the description box. You can go check out what it entails and all that. You don't have to if you don't want to though. Watching, commenting, you know, engaging, it is very supportive and very much appreciated as well. So that is it. Thank you so, so much for watching. I think I already said that, didn't I? Yeah. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.